Who can you trust to take care of your children when you're at work? Finding quality childcare can be a major challenge. Doug Johnson has some tips on what to look for.
Parents face tough choices. They want the joys of family and children, but are faced with the realities of the world. Jobs and other obligations that will take them away from their loved ones for hours nearly every day. For the Bateman family, that meant finding someone to take care of 2.5-year-old Quinn and year-old Oliver.
I think it can be a difficult process. Certainly from our experience, we looked at a number of daycares and schools in the area, and they have, and a lot of them we felt comfortable with. But we did want to make sure we checked it out. And so as a working parent, that takes time.
If parents don't have the option of being able to rely on other family, they'll have to look for a person or program that will fit their needs, their budget, and their child's personalities. Pediatricians recommend doing research before making a decision.
I usually recommend that parents try to get some references from other people who may be in their community who've used the facilities before. Obviously going to the facility, and particularly finding out what their policy is on having parents visit the facility before they put their children in.
I was looking for a place that had a parent handbook so that I kind of knew how a regular day went for my kids. And then I think just as a mom, I was looking for somewhere that made me comfortable and that I felt like was warm and welcoming and a place where my kids were going to be loved.
The American Academy of Pediatrics has developed guidelines for the recommended numbers of adult caregivers in child care settings. For overall care of infants, the ratio should be 3 children to 1 staff person. For children 2 to 2.5 years old, the ratio should be 4 to 1. 2.5 to 3 years, 5 to 1. 3 years old, 7 to 1. And for children 4 to 5 years old, the ratio can be 8 children to 1 staff member.
First of all, parents need to decide what kind of learning environment or what type of child care they want. There are home-based daycares, which are more just care situations where someone is simply taking care of your child. Then there are more learning-based environments, preschool, nursery school, Head Start programs that have more of a focus on actually school preparedness and adding, in addition to just taking care of your children, but some educational component.
About 70% of parents put their kids in some type of daily care, whether it's in-home or center-based, preschool, or in someone else's home. Tennessee's Department of Human Services does license child care centers, group child care homes, and family child care homes that provide care for 5 or more children. It also provides information for parents. Go to tn.gov and search child care for details.
You know, so you should be able to ask wherever you're going to send your children what the qualifications are of the people who will be watching your children, if there's someone there or present on the facility all the time that's certified in CPR. These are kind of the, just from a medical standpoint, the things that you want to ask just in terms of safety.
It may take some time and effort for parents to find the right place for their children, but it's worth it to find a place that will provide the right type of care. For Smart Medicine, I'm Doug Johnson.